What's going on, everybody? My name's Tenebris Infinite, and welcome to 10 Rapid Fire Tips for Farming the Reaper. I've got 5 combat tips and 5 general tips for farming the Reaper, so let's not waste any time and jump right in. So first things first, let's start with the combat tips. When you're fighting the Reaper creates this red barrier around himself. In order to stop that barrier, you have to shoot the 4 points of generators on his body. He's got 2 on his knees and 2 on his upper shoulder areas. You can shoot the ones on the knees kind of through his armor and through the knees with the experimental PVG. But if you don't have the experimental PVG, you want to bring along some sort of armor-piercing ammo so that that way you could take off his knee plates as quickly as possible so that you can expose those knee generator points and take them down quickly and efficiently. With every single generator that you manage to destroy off the Reaper, it kind of increases the cooldown time he has before he can put his shield generator back up. So, in order to maximize the amount of damage that you can do to the Reaper, you want to take out these shield generators so that that way you can leave him defenseless. The next tip is to get the Reaper to charge you, to get him to do his running attack. You can do this by kind of creating a decent amount of distance between you and the Reaper, somewhere close to like 100 meters between you and the Reaper, and he'll generally attempt to charge you most of the time. The benefit of getting the Reaper to charge you is that a lot of times after he's done his charge attack, or shortly before he starts his charge attack, he'll actually drop his shield. This creates multiple opportunities for you to do as much damage as possible, potentially before you've even destroyed the shield generators on him. The other benefit that this gives you is it gives you the ability to kind of manipulate the position of the Reaper, so you can get him into a spot where you have kind of the best advantage against him. You either have lots of cover around you, or you've got him in a position where he can't damage you. Next up, let's talk about the thermobaric blast that the Reaper puts off. The thermobaric blast is a bit of a desperation attack that the Reaper puts out. After you've done a significant amount of damage, he'll start popping off these thermobaric blasts that are a one-shot against your character. But luckily, there is a way around it. So, you can either use buildings to protect yourself, you can use trees to protect yourself, or you can just use large rocks or anything in your vicinity that's going to significantly cover your character. The main thing that the Reaper's blast wave is checking for is your shoulders. So whenever you're hiding behind a tree, instead of facing towards the tree, you want to kind of face to the side instead, so that that way you're covering your shoulders and covering your character as much as possible. Another pro tip too is that usually the Reaper will put out 2 thermobaric attacks, one after the other. Sometimes he won't, but most of the time you should try to anticipate a secondary thermobaric attack. But if you don't happen to have any cover, the thermobaric blast has a radius of about 175 meters. To be absolutely safe, you always want to run 200 meters away from the thermobaric blast, just to make sure that you're covering all your bases and making sure that you're avoiding that desperation attack one shot. And the next tip is to pay attention to the visual tells that the Reaper gives you when he's about to attack you. So the first visual tell that the Reaper gives you is whether or not he's going to attack with either his machine gun or his mortar. These will spark with some red electricity just before he fires them off. So as long as you're paying attention for that red electricity, you can anticipate either the machine gun or the mortar, and you can kind of like plan your movement based around that visual tell. If he's going to be firing his machine gun, you generally want to be sprinting as fast as you can, either left or right, strafing away from that fire. And when it's the mortar, you kind of want to be a little bit more reactive, because he fires those rockets just kind of all over the place. The next visual tell is for the thermobaric attack. Your boy the Reaper rips some serious ass before he puts off this explosion. So when he's about to do the explosion, pay attention for the audible tell of him sounding off with his foghorn, and then pay attention for that massive gas cloud. You totally can't miss it before he does his attack. The moment you see that, you know it's time to either run for the hills or get yourself behind some sort of cover. And lastly, the final visual tell that he'll give you, which is really truly the final visual tell, is right before he's about to do his suicide attack. Instead of putting off a big plume of gas like he does for his normal thermobaric, he'll actually start emitting this red smoke instead. And this red smoke is a sign that that's going to be the suicide bomb. That's going to be the explosion that kills him and potentially you at the same time. So that's when you really need to crunch out that extra final bit of damage and just take the Reaper down as quickly as possible. If you don't get the kill against the Reaper, you wind up getting worse loot, so you really want to pay attention for the suicide red gas that he puts out right at the end of the fight, because otherwise you've kind of wasted a lot of resources to getting only subpar loot. So definitely pay attention for this red gas when you know that you've done a ton of damage and he should be going down at any moment. And the last tip here is specifically for that last-ditch attack that he'll do at the end of the fight. So in order to have clean takedowns on the Reaper every single time, you want to make sure that you're leaving some components on him undestroyed, but heavily damaged. The reason for this is that whenever you destroy a component on a machine, it does a nice little boost of damage towards the overall health of the machine. So if you've got a whole bunch of components that you can destroy really easily with just a few bullets, you can take him down really, really quickly right from the point where you notice that red smoke. So whether or not it's the thighs, the knees, the body, the guns, the eyes, the ear mufflers, the little funny hat on top, you want to damage some of those and keep them in mind for the end of the fight so that way you can ensure that you're always getting the kill and you're always getting that fat loot from the Reaper. Now for some general tips about how to farm the Reaper. So outside of combat, there is a little bit that goes in behind actually getting the Reaper into your world. First things first, the Reaper spawns after level 20, and so that means from 21 to 25, you have a chance for the Reaper to spawn in that specific region. So with each increasing level, the Reaper has a higher chance of spawning. So you really want to aim to have your level around, you know, 23, 24, somewhere ballpark to that, or even just maxed out at 25, in order to ensure that the next rival that you summon will actually wind up being the Reaper. And on that note, the Reaper takes up a rival slot. So since the Reaper takes up a rival slot and you can only have a maximum of 8 rivals in a specific region at once, you want to make sure that you're always culling off at least one of those rivals in order to make sure that you are keeping that slot free for the Reaper to spawn. Or, if you don't want to be constantly killing off that 8th rival, you can keep the 8 rivals, but you'll have to grind your region up to 24 or 25 to ensure that the experience loss that you get when you kill that rival is not going to be knocking you below the point of level 20, so that way you can, again, just make sure that that Reaper's going to spawn. The next tip is that after a rival spawns in a region, you want to farm like an absolute mad lad. So you can see here that in the South Coast region, this is pretty much peak efficiency for Reaper farming in a region. So you notice that for my active rivals, I only have 5 rivals that are active, with the Reaper being the 5th rival. So the idea is in order to efficiently ensure that that Reaper is going to be spawning and that you aren't cutting off too much of your experience and kind of taking like a step backwards every time you take two steps forwards, you want to make sure that the moment that that eighth rival or that next rival, whatever rival, has spawned, that you're just taking advantage of it and you're just farming like absolute crazy. Because that way you can ensure that you're maximizing your region score and your region level, but you're keeping your rival count as low as humanly possible. For the ninth tip here, it's something that's kind of like an obvious tip, but is one that I haven't seen many people talk about or potentially kind of think about very much when they're fighting the Reaper. And that's that the Reaper, just like all the enemies in Generation Zero, is a persistent enemy. So you can definitely do hit and run attacks against the Reaper. You don't have to just white knuckle it and take him down in one go. You can hit him and take down his shields and then back off for like, I don't know, like an hour or two while you're going off and farming or something like that, and then go back at it and hit him again, and then you can kind of rinse and repeat until you take the Reaper down. The only kind of hard part is keeping in mind how much damage you've done to him, because again, he'll have that last ditch attack. But yeah, you could definitely treat this Reaper the same as you would treat any other enemy in Generation Zero, and damage him a little bit, and then leave him for a later point in time. And lastly, for the final tip, this is just my own personal preference here, but I also feel like there's a bit of logic that goes behind it. The focus regions that you want to have for farming the Reaper is the Southern Coast, the Farmlands, and Himfjell Island. The reasoning behind this is that in these regions, you can fight the highest amount of apocalypse machines in comparison to any of the other regions. And so this is a huge benefit when it comes to farming a lot of score really, really quickly. This way, you're going to be able to get as much score as possible from the machines you're downing, and progressing your region level and your region score up to that threshold of level 20 as quickly as possible. Now, you could totally argue that the Marshlands and the North Coast are both equally good regions to try to farm the Reaper from, but in my own personal finding, these three regions of the Farmlands, the Southern Coast, and Himfjell, they've just been the fastest for having a Reaper kind of turnover rate. So there you go, my dudes, 10 rapid fire tips for taking down the Reaper. This was kind of a new thing for me. Normally I really deliberate on my tips and tricks, but this time I tried to make something that was really compressed so that that way if anybody needed just quick tips for the Reaper, that they would have a video that they could watch and chunk down in like 10 minutes or less and have some excellent tips for taking on the Reaper. So let me know, how did I do? Did I do a good job? Is this something that you would like to see in the future? Or do you prefer me really taking my time and really deliberating on my tips and tricks? Let me know in the comments down below. And if this video was helpful for you, maybe consider hitting that thumbs up button. But for now, I've been Tenebris, you've been awesome. Thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you dudes in the next one. Until then, peace.